Hello all, my name is Ashutosh. I am a teacher by profession. My mission is to impart quality education for all. For that purpose, I am creating these videos. If you appreciate my work, then please do like my video and subscribe my channel so that I could get the motivation to prepare more videos. Anyways, today in this particular lecture, we will going to discuss about the detection of DSBSC signal, in which we will going to discuss about your synchronous detection method. That is how, with the help of synchronous detection method, we will going to demodulate or detect our DSBSC signal. So these are the outlines. We're going to start up with the introduction, where we will going to describe whatever we have studied in our last lecture. Then we'll going to discuss about your synchronous detection method. After giving this block diagram description of your synchronous detection method, we will going to discuss various sorts of error in your synchronous detection, such as your phase error and frequency error. So in our last lecture, we have studied about the generation methods of your DSBSC signal, such as our balance modulation and your ring modulator. We have also found out the mathematical equation of your DSBSC signal, as DSBSC of t would have been given as AC times of MA upon 2 cos of 2 pi FC plus FMT, which is nothing but your upper sideband, plus cos of 2 pi FC minus FMT, which is nothing but your lower sideband. So in our DSBSC signal, we will going to possess both these sidebands, that is your upper sideband and your lower sideband. So in this particular lecture, we will try to discuss about the synchronous detection method of your DSBSC signal. That is how our modulated DSBSC signal will get demodulated or detected with the help of this synchronous detection method. So synchronous AM demodulation provides some significant improvement over the simple diode detector. While studying this diode detector, we have seen that due to the time constant of our capacitor, we are going to have some distorted outcome. That is, if time constant value is higher, then in that particular case, we are not in a state to replicate the signal variation instantaneously. Whereas if we will going to have this time constant value much lower, then in that particular case, our ripple value will going to be higher. In both the cases, we will going to have some distorted outcome at the receiver. So all these problems would have been rectified with the help of this synchronous detection. So the improvement in performance of synchronous detector requires the use of additional components and sophistication, which increases the cost. In your synchronous detection, we basically need that the carrier signal information must be available at the receiving side so that we can detect our signal properly with the help of product multiplier. So synchronous detectors are generally used in high performance receiver where cost is not an issue. So obviously, if we will going to impose this particular condition that our receiver will going to have some exact carrier signal detail at the receiving side and we will going to exploit that particular information, for that particular sake, we need some extra circuitry which will going to give us that sort of information. So obviously, we will be requiring some additional component, which conversely going to increase the cost. So obviously, synchronous detection technique would have been applied at those places where cost is not an issue, where best quality is our major agenda. So now this particular slide is basically showing your DSBSC synchronous detection block diagram structure. So here at the input side, we'll be having this DSBSC signal, which would have been represented by this ST. It would have been applied to your product modulator, whose second input is your local carrier oscillator, whose value is your cos of 2 pi FCT. Here one should keep in mind that this FC frequency is the same frequency that would have been used at your transmitting side while modulation. So this product multiplier outcome will going to pass through your low pass filter, and at the output side we will going to get this distortionless message signal or exact message signal. So this is how we will going to demodulate our DSBSC signal. So let us understand it in much more descriptive way. So the DSBSC wave ST is applied to the product modulator, in which it is multiplied with the locally generated carrier signal, which is nothing but your cos of 2 pi FCT, where this FC frequency is your carrier frequency that would have been used at your transmitting side also for modulation purpose. Here this locally generated carrier is exactly coherent or synchronized in both frequency and phase with the original carrier wave CT. So this is the important point, that is, if we are in a state to match the exact same characteristics of our carrier signal at your receiving side, then we can detect our signal properly. Otherwise, if there is some sort of error in your locally generated carrier signal, then we are not in a state to get the exact message signal and it will going to produce some distorted outcome. So what are they? We really need to study that. And in our upcoming slides, we'll try to take them up one by one. So this method of detection is therefore called as your coherent detection or synchronous detection, since we really wanted that the transmitting side carrier signal and your receiving side carrier signal both are completely synchronized with each other. So if the locally generated carrier is not synchronized, then we receive some distorted signal, as we have discussed. So there exist two types of error in your DSBSC synchronous detection, that is your phase error and your frequency error. So obviously, if we are talking about your locally generated carrier frequency, if it is having certain sort of differences with the actual carrier wave, then we will going to have this sort of error, that is your phase error and your frequency error. So what are they and how we can rectify them? We will going to discuss both of them one by one. So now we're going to discuss the synchronous detection error. So this is the block diagram structure of our synchronous detector that we have studied in our first slide also. At the input side, we'll be having this your DSBSC signal, which will going to pass through your product multiplier, whose second input is your carrier signal, which is being given as your cos of omega CT when it is completely synchronized. But here in this particular case, while studying this phase error, we are assuming that the locally generated carrier signal value will be equal to cos of omega CT plus theta. That is, as far as omega CT point of concern, it is same, but it is having a phase difference of theta. If your locally generated carrier signal will going to have phase difference theta in comparison to your transmitted carrier signal, then how our message signal will going to behave, we have to analyze it. So here at this particular point, the output signal would have been given as your empty times of cos of omega CT, which is nothing but your DSBSC signal multiplied with your this carrier signal, that is your cos of omega CT plus theta. Since we will be having discrimination in your phase angle theta than the original carrier frequency, so we have just multiplied these two, this DSBSC signal and your locally generated carrier signal, and at the output we will going to receive this. While solving this particular thing, what we are get is YT will be equal to empty times of half of cos of 2 omega CT plus theta plus empty times of 1 upon 2 cos of minus theta. So we just try to simply apply this 2 cos A cos B formula into that particular thing, and we are getting this. So while further analyzing it, what we are going to get is empty times of half of cos theta plus empty times of half of cos of 2 omega CT plus theta. So these two components we will going to get at the input of your low pass filter. So here the condition is local carrier oscillator has the same frequency but different phase compared to the carrier signal at the transmitter. If this is the case, then this condition will going to happen. So this particular figure is basically showing your frequency domain representation of these components. That is, this particular point will be having this omega m frequency component, which is equivalent to this empty times of half of cos theta. Whereas this particular portion is signifying the component associated with this particular term. So this is our information signal, that is empty times of half of cos theta, and this is your high frequency term, which would have been rejected by this low pass filter. So if the critical frequency of low pass filter is analogous to your FM, which is nothing but the maximum frequency component of your message signal, then we will going to only obtain this particular component at the output of your low pass filter. So instead of getting or receiving this message signal empty, what we are getting is we are getting the product of empty times of half of cos theta, which will going to gives us some oscillatory outcome instead of this original message signal empty. So due to this particular thing, we will going to receive our signal as a distorted one. So if we really wanted to avoid that, then the condition is there should be no phase error or theta value should be equal to zero. Then in that particular case, cos theta or cos 0 value turns out to be unity, and we are getting this empty upon 2. So with complete synchronization, we can avoid this phasing error. So here the outcome VT will be equal to half of empty times of cos theta. So the impact of this cos theta, we have already discussed that we will going to get this attenuated oscillatory outcome instead of receiving this sole empty. So next problem is your frequency error. That is, again, this particular figure is basically showing your DSBSC detector circuitry. So the first input is your DSBSC signal, and second input is your local carrier oscillator, whose frequency value would have been given as your omega CT plus delta omega. So here we can see that phase difference value is zero, or there will be no theta. But the point is, here we have got the frequency error by this delta omega. So if this is the carrier signal value, then how we will going to obtain our message signal? Let us understand it with some mathematical equation. So the outcome of this multiplier circuitry would be given by your the product of these two components, that is your DSBSC signal and your locally generated carrier signal, that will be equal to mt times of cos of omega ct, which is nothing but your DSBSC signal multiplied with your cos of omega ct plus delta omega. So here this delta omega is your frequency error in your local oscillator. So when we're going to solve this particular thing, what we are left with is your yt is equal to mt times of half of cos of 2 omega ct plus delta omega plus mt times of 1 upon 2 cos of minus delta omega. Here again we have applied this 2 cos A cos B formula. That will be equal to cos of A plus B upon 2 plus cos of A minus B upon 2. So we are getting this specific outcome. Further solving this particular thing, what we are left with is your mt times of half of cos of delta omega plus mt times of half of cos of twice of omega ct plus delta omega. Here again this particular term is your high frequency term that would have been centered around your twice of omega c. So when we're going to pass through this low pass filter, which is tuned at your message signal frequency, that is fm, so we will simply going to discard that particular thing and we are left with this particular portion only. So here in this particular case the condition is local oscillator has the same phase but different frequency compared to the carrier signal at the transmitter. So due to this frequency variation we are getting this sort of outcome instead of your mt. So this particular figure is basically showing the frequency domain representation of these particular components. So one component is centered around your omega m, which would have been represented this particular term. So this particular arrow will basically representing this particular term, and these two arrows are basically representing this particular term, that is your upper side band as well as your lower side band, which is given by these two components, which is centered around your twice of omega c. So this particular component is basically showing the information part. Instead of mt we are receiving this mt times of 1 upon 2 cos of delta omega, and this particular term is your high frequency term which will simply rejected by your low pass filter. So the outcome of low pass filter will be this particular information term only, and instead of your message signal mt what we are getting is vt is equal to half of mt times of cos of delta omega. So due to this cos of delta omega term we will further going to get some attenuated as well as oscillatory outcome instead of this mt. So obviously we will going to get some distorted outcome in this particular case also. So if we really wanted to avoid it, then the only idea is we should make this frequency error value will be equal to 0. That is when delta omega will be equal to 0, then in that particular case we are in a state to receive the actual message signal value mt. So hopefully you guys have got the insight about that is how with the help of your synchronous detection method we can detect our DSBSC signal and different types of errors that exist in your DSBSC signal demodulation. In case of any doubt you can ask me in the comment section. I'll try to solve them out as soon as possible. So these are the references. Thank you very much for your patient hearing.